Wow, that was Elmer Benson. He won the election, you know. Governor of Minnesota in 1936. It's hard to imagine now that we had a socialist governor. McCarthyism kind of changed everything. I forgot what an awesome political history we have here. And that Martin McGowan was like a local Groucho Marx. My dad used to talk about how funny he was. He wrote a column every week in the paper. Man.
Wait a minute. Stop this right now. What do you think you're doing?
I, for one, am about to give one of these city kids a knuckle sandwich.
Yeah!
Wait a minute. What's all the rivalry about anyhow? Farm kids? Town kids? What's the difference? We're all from Appleton. Some of you grew up on the farm, and some in town. You're not all that different.
Except that farm kids smell like cow manure.
And city kids tuck their shirts in like a bunch of sissies.
Yeah? Well, farm kids don't wear shoes.
And city kids can't do anything for themselves.
Their mommies have to wipe their little noses.
Well, farm kids, supposes their noses are roses.
Just for that one, I'm gonna give you a black eye.
Hold on a minute. Are you serious? Listen to yourselves. You're operating under false assumptions. Wait! Look around you. For just one second. You need one another.
What kind of bull are you talking?
You need one another to survive. How many of you farm kids come to town every Saturday night for a movie at the Reno Theater, huh? Where'd you get that haircut, Priscilla? That's right, the same place Jan got hers cut. Where'd you get those clothes, Harvey?
JCPenney?
You need the town just as much as the town needs you.
We don't need them mud rubbers.
Oh yeah? Where do you think your parents get the milk you drink every day, Jan? The eggs you ate for breakfast this morning, Alice? What do you think this bread is made from? Does corn grow on trees? Your food comes from the farm, and these kids' families are growing and raising your food for you. You all are so immature.
Well, what do you expect us to do about it? Farm kids and town kids have been fighting ever since Addison Phelps named this town.
Yeah!
Just because they always did it doesn't mean that you have to. Think for yourselves. Just think for a minute about all the things we could be doing right now if we weren't fighting. I'm serious. Think about it.
We could be swimming at the pool.
Good.
We could be at the Funkelstrews Brothers Bazaar.
We could be talking to Clarence Lundquist down at the popcorn stand.
Very good, Iris. Priscilla, what about you?
Well, I guess I could be buying some beef jerky from Earl Sinsdalen.
Or I could be sitting in Bob Miller's dentist chair.
Or talking to the walrus down at Schramm's dime store.
I'll give you a nickel if you touch its mustache.
Honestly, I'd rather be down at the candy kitchen getting some ice cream.
My mom says I should be getting the haircut.
See? There's a boatload of things we could all be doing right now rather than fighting. What are we fighting for anyway?
Because farm kids smell like cow manure.
I know. You already said that, and it's boring. You want to know what I think? I think you're suffering from a lack of imagination, and you're stuck in the same old way of doing things. We all know that every person here could be spending their time more wisely. Let's be honest, our parents aren't always the best role models, so let's show them a thing or two.